You know the video is gonna be fun if I have to put the gloves on. Sometimes people give me their garbage, I mean their old electronics. You know, stuff I can repair or salvage parts from. Today I'll be taking apart these electronic cigarettes. It is sad that people just throw these in the trash. Not only because they cause pollution, but also because all of these contain lithium-ion batteries. Rechargeable lithium-ion batteries, in fact, which I want to salvage. Now is a good time to say do not do this at home. Lithium-ion batteries can be dangerous and should be treated with respect. This video is for your entertainment only. With that disclaimer out of the way, all of these come apart the same way, more or less. If I wiggle the mouthpiece with my pliers, all of the spicy guts come out. And this here is the battery I'm interested in. The next unit has an almost identical design. This spongy bit holds the special liquid, and it's the reason why I'm wearing gloves right now. Behind it is the battery. It looks a lot like an electrolytic capacitor, but it is actually a lithium-ion battery in a capacitor package. This white one is similar in construction and comes apart the same way. Inside it there is a slightly bigger battery. And this green one looks special. It has a USB port, presumably to recharge its battery, so it looks like it is not meant to be disposable. Too bad that it ended in the garbage. It also has a tiny display, and the biggest battery I've taken out so far. This red one didn't want to come apart. It was like the battery was glued in there, so I had to pull really hard to get it unstuck. That was a bad idea. I shorted the wires in the process, and then one more time off camera. This melted the insulation of the wire and even burned my finger slightly. This is a reminder you should be careful when dealing with lithium-ion batteries. So in total, I extracted 7 battery cells. The question now is if they're still good to use. The one I shorted earlier is probably toast. As for the rest, I checked the voltages on every one of them. Lithium-ion cells must not be over-discharged. This cell is at 2.9 volts, so it is still usable. However, this other one is at 1.2 volts. It is likely not good anymore, so it's getting recycled. This one is at 2.8 volts. This one is at 3.3. It is unfortunate that the biggest cell is at almost 0 volts. It could have been useful. And I am surprised by how much tech they put into some of these. If I plug a charger into this module, I get a brand logo and a battery level meter. So in the end, I got 4 usable battery cells and 3 over-discharged, which I'm going to bring for recycling. What should I make with the good ones? Let me know in the comments.